Garcia.
Thank you guys for coming today. Sorry for the wait, but we're here now. Thank you. I want to thank Golden Boy Promotions, obviously GTD Promotions, Showtime, DAZN. We really came together and really conquered the poison that's been stopping boxing from having the biggest fights. It wasn't easy, but you know, we found a way. This has been a fight that I've wanted for a very long time, and because for me, to be a champion, you have to beat the best. It's not about the titles. It's not about, you know, like I said, the titles. It's about who you beat. And for me, it's testimony to the respect I got for him as a fighter. To me, I believe he's one of the best, and I've had that type of mentality since I was a young kid growing up in the amateurs. Is I never thought about the weight class. I only thought about who was in it. So I want to be the best. And during this whole journey, I definitely put boxing first and the fans first, because I had to accept a lot of stipulations. They know it, you know, going down in weight, rehydration clause. I don't want to bring up too much, but those are the little things that I said to myself, you know what, if I put myself first, I should say no. But my heart don't let me. I got the character of a champion, and my power comes from within and from above. No matter what weight I'm down to, no matter what I have to do, my strength comes from here. I don't look like I hit hard, but I do hit hard. The punches, they just come quick, but when they hit you, you're just down. So I want to also, almost forgot, I want to thank Jesus Christ. Thank you so much. Glorious moment, I want to give to Jesus. Thank you. Above all, April 22nd, this is the time where the words don't matter no more. The truth will come out. We're all about the truth. He's a great fighter. I'm a great fighter. We settle in the ring. Whoever wins holds the crown. Let's get it.
Man, back at it. This time we got another dance partner. You know what I mean? Coming up, I watch Floyd and, you know what I mean, Oscar. Also, Bernard Hopkins, you know what I mean, and Joe Goosen and things like that. And I know that, you know what I mean, it's gonna be tough. You know what I mean, this fight gonna be tough. I feel as though that, you know what I mean, this is what we came to do. You know what I mean, I've been boxing since I was 7 years old. I fought a lot coming up, so I'm just happy to be a part of this moment, sharing the ring with a young fighter like Ryan Garcia, that's willing to dare himself to be great. He talked his way into this fight, and April the 22nd, he's going to have to be able to show it. You know what I mean? I'm coming from, you know what I mean, where I come from, Baltimore City, the inner city. A lot of people don't make it from there, so again, I'm just happy to be a part of this fight, you know what I mean, this event. I want to thank Showtime, Al Haymon, Golden Boy, Ryan, Joe Goosen, you know what I mean, and I want to thank, you know what I mean, God, you know what I mean, my personal team and things like that, because I couldn't have did this by myself. You know what I mean, I had a great team, a great personal team and things like that. As far as like my personal team, my coaches, my support system, and kept me up. You know what I mean? I've been, again, keeping my head down and stay grinding in and out the gym. You know what I mean? We had a lot of people that talked down on us and things like that, but we stay focused and keep our head down a little bit and continue to grind. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, that's what really matters, you know what I mean? So, April the 22nd, Brian and Javante, big event. Make sure y'all buy the pay-per-view. If y'all can't buy the pay-per-view, make sure y'all show up, you know what I mean? So, thank y'all for having me, and see y'all April the 22nd.
We talked about how big this fight is, mega fight, super fight. What you tell the people, in your opinion, why is this fight with you and Ryan so important to the sport?
I think it's important because both of us young. You know what I mean? I'm a little older than Ryan, but you know what I mean? I think that both of us at our peak, you know what I mean? A lot of young fighters don't fight each other, and I feel as though this is a stepping stone for, you know, the other younger fighters to get in the ring with each other. So I feel as though that, you know what I mean? We both made our name coming up, you know what I mean? And the time is now. You know what I mean? Like I said before, he a great fighter. I'm a great fighter. And we put it all on the line, April the 22nd.
Ryan, same question. Why is this fight so important to the sport?
I mean, if you look at boxing in the position it is right now, it's been hard to get prime fighters to get them, right? It's usually too late or, you know, somebody's way past their prime.
You've talked about quieting the doubters and how some have criticized you for your choice of opponents that you had been protected for all these years. Does all of that go away on April 22nd?
Hopefully, but they always find something else to say. So, I mean, like I said, all I gotta do is keep my head down and continue to grind, be whoever they put in front of me. And that's start with Ryan Garcia.
Ryan, everyone I think in the sport knows how talented you are as a fighter. But I think there's some who criticize you only for the social media following that you have and maybe don't take you as serious. Does all that come to an end on April 22nd?
For sure, I believe so. Obviously, Tank has the image of a devastating puncher, dangerous, and to me, he's a great fighter. So within myself, I would know for sure what type of fighter I am. You understand? I've been doing this since I was, like himself, 7 years old, over 200 amateur fights. So this is what I've always wanted. This is it. Pay-per-view. This is all, you know, everybody's here. So for me, I think it's destroying the image of, you know, judging a book by its cover. It's easy. I'm an easy person to target when it comes to, you know, he's not serious. You know, he's doing TikToks, whatever. But I wouldn't be here if that was true. If that was my main focus, I wouldn't be on this stage. It's quite clear. So this is the fight right here. Whoever wins, all that goes away.
Get these late round stoppages. Does that change on April 22nd, considering now you're fighting a young guy who's got some powerful hands? He usually brings it at the beginning of the fight.
It depends on what he brings that night. If he come in like fast or he's coming slow, then I always want to take my time, you know what I mean? But it all depends on Ryan Garcia, what he bring come April the 22nd.
Ryan, along those lines, you told the media, quote, "I'm knocking Tank Davis out in 2 rounds. If he's a tank, I'm an RPG. Tell us why this is going to be an early stoppage April 22nd.
You made that sound corny, man. Like,
should I try it again?
No, you're good. That was me. I said that, right?
Yeah.
You know, when I say things like second round, if you asked for a prediction, I gave you one. To me, I'm going to be ready for 12. You understand? And you have to respect the fighter going in. You can't just jump in and try to get a knockout. I mean, it's quite clear. You know, anybody with a strategic mind would think that. So, for me, it might be more of a thinking fight than people may believe. With different opponents, you got to approach it different ways. When he's in front of you and you see what he's attempting, it might not make you take that shot. Or, you know, you might have to make adjustments on the way. There's a lot of little intricates in fights that cause you to make adjustments. So, I don't know how I'm going to come out. Like I said, it's a dance.
They say he was talking out the ass. I'm talking on the ass.
Hey, someone got to promote it. I was here on time, right?
That's cool. You're supposed to be like that.
So, what do you mean?
You're supposed to be like that.
I don't understand. What do you mean by that? I'm supposed to be like that. I'm professional. I am.
That's cool.
So Tank, he's wanted this fight a long time. There's an old adage, be careful what you ask for. What is he getting April 22nd?
Say it again, I'm sorry.
There's an old adage, you know, you gotta be careful what you ask for when you want something. So what is Ryan Garcia getting on April 22nd?
A ass whooping. That's what he getting.
We'll wrap it up with this. Ryan, for that sold out arena and those thousands of people who are gonna pay hard earned money. Those people who are gonna pay their hard earned money for Showtime pay-per-view. What can you guarantee they're gonna get on April 22nd when you step into the ring with Gervonta Davis?
I guarantee you a classic. It's gonna be a classic fight. I guarantee that. You're gonna remember this for a long time.
Tank Davis, same question. For those folks who are gonna pay their hard-earned money, come out to Las Vegas, or order the fight on Showtime pay-per-view, what can you guarantee they're gonna get when you face Ryan Garcia?
A explosive fight. Two young guys that's hungry. You know what I mean? It's just who won them all. Who built like that, that's who gonna win. That's who gonna really win. Nobody can fight for him. Nobody can fight for me. It's about who really won him, who really got that dog in him. That's who gonna win.
That's your quote. Who's gonna win? The person who's built like that. Mm. That's what's going down April 22nd, when these two unbeaten, explosive fighters go at it in the fight capital of the world, Las Vegas. Again, it comes your way on Showtime pay-per-view. Tickets go on sale. That is Friday, March 10th. They can be purchased through AXS.com.
Oh my God, delay. What's the delay?
It's on.
What's the delay, man?
Gervonta Davis.
Ellie Seckback. Ellie Seckback reporting.
But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.